And today we're going to be starting by lying down on our backs with the soles of the feet together and the knees out wide. Now, if you find in this position it's not comfortable for your hips or your knees, feel free to put some supports underneath the knees. You could use a blanket if you've got that handy, or some bricks or books. And what you want to do is to have the same support either side. So make sure that the back is comfortable. Try to lengthen the tailbone towards the heels. And we're looking to soften into the groin, into the abdomen, and allow that breath to expand into that softening. So focus on that nice breath in through the nose, expanding into the belly, releasing, relaxing on that exhalation. Allowing the breath to maybe become a little deeper, a little longer. And then we'll look at it, taking that into what we call our three-part yogic breath. So we try to breathe, first of all, into the lower abdominal area. So we're trying to access the lower lungs. Then our second part of the breath is here in the rib cage. So you may want to have both hands just either side of the ribs. And as you inhale, we're going to draw the breath into the ribs, get that sense of expansion out and up, and on the exhale, that contraction through the ribcage. If you can keep the belly fairly neutral as we focus on the breath through the ribs, and then our third part of the breath is up here at the chest, so towards the collarbones, upper chest, and you may want to place one hand just here around in the sternum below the collarbones. It's a shallower breath, so as we inhale, it's not too deep. As we exhale, we want to feel the shoulders relax, collarbones relax. So just a few breaths here. And then releasing that. Now, if at any time your legs aren't comfortable, feel free to come out and you can prop them against each other. If you're happy staying with this bound angle position, that's great as well. So now combining all three parts of the breath. So maybe place one hand on that lower abdominal area, just below the belly button. Maybe one hand on the ribs. And direct the breath into that lower hand. Then draw it into the rib cage, and we finish the breath up at the top of the collarbones. As you exhale, allow the breath to move from the upper chest, allow the ribs to contract, and then allowing the belly to sink towards the floor. So now focusing on that three-part breath. Exhale out through that last three-part breath. Return back to what you find is a comfortable breathing pattern. So this is a good breath to really try and utilize the whole lung or both lungs, and it's a conscious way of breathing. So if you can take time out a couple of times a day just to focus on really expanding into all three parts of the lungs, taking those conscious breaths, calming down the nervous system, and then you revert back to your normal breathing. So from here, let's bring both knees back in towards each other. We'll place the feet on the floor, keep the knees bent. And just a tiny little roll through the spine. So I'm not pushing through my feet. What I'm doing is breathing in, creating a little bit more arch in the back here. And then as I exhale, just releasing and pressing down with the abdomen and lower back to floor. It's just a couple of nice easy movements through the spine. And then we'll take both knees in towards the chest, just a nice little squeeze. Press the back against the floor, shoulders down. And then release the feet back to the floor. Now we'll be going into some leg stretches and taking legs up into the air. You've got the choice if you don't have a strap within reach, you know, you could use a tie, whatever you've got at home. You can also just hold behind the back of the leg. So we're going to take the right leg up into the air. And if you do have that strap position, you may want to place it around the ball of the foot. You just need a little bit of a loop. And then try to extend the ball of the foot a little bit higher than the heel. I've got my toes pulling back towards the face, drawing up through the kneecap. Keeping this left leg nice and relaxed and getting that sense of the thigh bone dropping into its hip joint. So it's really sitting down in here nice and snug. Now at this point, we don't really want to be looking for a super strong stretch. We're starting to get a little bit aggravated. So see if you can soften into it. And maybe you could hold behind the back of the leg. If you're quite tight and you haven't got a strap, maybe you might even have to have that knee a little bit soft as well for that. Otherwise, you're placing that leg wherever we comfortably can without gritting the teeth with the effort. And then we come back to that breath awareness. So just ensuring that the belly rises as we breathe in and relaxes to the floor on that exhalation. And then on the next exhale, let's extend that left leg out along the floor. So just increasing that stretch a little bit more. Reach out through the left heel. Press the left thigh to the ground. We notice where the sensations are in the back of this right leg, whether it's in the buttocks, the hamstring, maybe it's in the calf. If it's very strong behind the back of the knee, perhaps softening that knee just a little bit. So hyperflexy people, try not to lock right backwards. Have that little micro bend in your knee. So let's re-bend into the left leg, and we might find now that we can ease that right leg just a little closer. So again, holding behind the back of the leg is fine. So for our next extension of this movement, you could stay holding onto a strap if you're using a strap, or you may prefer to hold behind the back of the leg. We are going to be lifting the head and shoulders just off the ground. So we take a deep breath in, and then on the exhalation, lifting head shoulders off the floor, drawing the body closer towards this right leg. So we're stretching now into the back as well as the glutes and the hamstring. We're going to breathe in and ease off with that leg stretch and relax the head and shoulders back to floor. So we'll do that two more times. Moving up on the exhalation. Brief little and soften. And then last time, exhale, lifting up. And then release. Relax back down. We're going to bring that right leg all the way down. Take both legs out along the floor. Give them a nice little shake. Notice how the right side feels to the left. And then let's bend both knees. And we'll take our left leg up into the air. So again, if you've got something handy to put around the foot, you can use that. Or if you prefer, you can simply hold behind the back of the leg. So not too strong to start off with. Focus on the breath. Relax that left thigh bone down into its hip joint. And as the sensation becomes perhaps a little gentler, finding a new stretch. On the exhale, let's start to extend the right leg now along the floor. And keeping ourselves focused on the different sensations that we have in the back of that left leg. Can we relax into the lower back as we hold? From here, bending into the right knee again. And you might be able to get a little bit more stretch now out of that left leg. Alright, either staying with the strap or you might prefer to hold behind the back of the leg. And we're going to take our head, shoulders off the floor as we exhale. So nice deep breath in. And then on the exhale, lifting head, shoulders off the floor. Maybe sliding this leg, hands up a little higher. And then we breathe in, we ease back off and relax the head and shoulders. So two more times with your breath. Keeping shoulders relaxed away from the ears. And try not to press too strong down into the right leg as we do this. Alright, releasing back down. Let's bring left leg down to the floor. Take both legs out. Nice little wrist relax all the way up to the head of the thighs. And then we'll take both knees in towards the chest, hands around each knee. Let's go for a nice rock side to side. Now from here, we'll be rolling all the way over. Trying to land on the equipment. Okay, and we're going to actually be lying on our stomachs. So if you want extra padding for your hips, you can put a blanket down. And we want to have the feet roughly width apart. So if possible, try to have all 10 toes connected with the floor. You might find the heels turn out a little bit when we do that. Coming into our Sphinx, so we bring the elbows underneath the shoulders, spread the hands out in front of the forearms, and then we simply lengthen through the chest, and we've got a lengthening through the upper arms here. The gaze is forward, so I don't want to throw my head all the way back, and I don't want my head dropped to the ground. Check that the back is comfortable. Make sure that the belly's on the floor, and we think about trying to get that opening in the upper ribcage area, the thoracic part of the spine. Now while we're here, with the 10 toes on the floor, the kneecaps should be drawing up, and we do that by tightening the quad muscles. And check that you're not squeezing the life out of your buttocks. So think of a little inner roll of the thighs to the ceiling to help keep the buttocks a bit more neutral. Now let's release. We'll take the elbows out. When we relax, either forehead on the hands, you could turn the head to the side. Some people like to have their arms down beside the body. All of it's good, as long as you are comfortable. If you are a head turner, make sure that you turn your head the other way when we come to rest again. All right, so next one, we want to wake up these back muscles a little bit more. We're going to bring the elbows in. Hands are quite nice and close now underneath the shoulders, but we're not going to use our hands. Keep your feet on the ground. So drop the kneecaps. Little contraction through the lower abdominal area so that you feel like the buttocks are extending towards the heels. We keep some space in the back. We're going to breathe in, lift the head, lift the chest, and then lift the arms off the floor, keeping the feet on the ground. So if you find the feet are lifting up, you're tensing too much into your legs and your buttocks. See if we can focus that strength in the upper back. And then we'll release, we come down on the exhale. And remember to turn the head the other way if you're a head turner, or keep it neutral. So take a good slow breath in, and a nice slower breath out. So now working into Bhujangasana, cobra pose. We'll keep the hands on the floor. Going for a gentle one to start with, so I've got my hands just a little higher than my head position. So my thumbs are lined up with my forehead. Elbows tend to be a bit wider, and the hands are wider than the shoulders. So press the feet to the floor, lift the kneecaps, lengthen the lower back. Breathe and lift the head and chest using the back strength. And as the exhale comes in, we can add some arm strength. Elbows soft. Draw them down, shoulders down, and chest is moving forwards. So if your back is not comfortable, please come lower. Breathe into the front belly, into the ribs, and this is where we're opening. Let's release on the exhale. We come down, we have a rest. Slow breath in, slow breath out. Now let's try a different hand position. So we're going to bring the hands just in front of the shoulders. Elbows now tuck into the rib cage. And we think of the elbow points moving towards the hips. Big down. Kneecaps up, breathing in with the head, with the chest, and then exhale, adding that arm strength, coming to where the back is going to be happy. If it's not happy, we stay low. If it is happy, also we can come up higher. Relax the shoulders, broad collarbones. So I don't want the collarbones crunching in. I'm going to draw them across, shoulder blades down and back. Can we breathe all the way down to the belly button? Release on the exhale. Come down. Have another rest. Check in with how you're feeling. Now we have one more cobra. Last one. If you want to go a little bit further, you could bring those hands all the way back through the chest. If you prefer not to lift up high, anything we've already done, you could come to a Sphinx is fine as well. So from here, press through the feet, lift the kneecaps, lengthen the lower back. Inhale, lift the head, lift the chest. Find that strength, add the arms. So thighs on the floor if we can, shoulders down and back. Optional little extra, whichever position you're in, try bending the knees and lifting the feet towards the head. So that's why we try and keep the pubic bone on the ground to do that. We're looking for the back bend. Lift and open up. All right, let's release it all back down. This time for our rest, can we have the big toes touch Let the heels fall away. And if you're familiar with your Ujjayi breath, that gentle contraction at the throat on the exhalation. So let's take the feet now a little bit wider. Have the head in a neutral position. And we're going to take the hips for a little rock side to side. And then we'll come back to our center. Bend at the knees and then just take the feet for a little side winder. And then we'll come back to center, feet back down. Let's bring the hands underneath so we can push up onto the knees. And then coming into a child pose, if we can keep the knees about hip width, so it's a bit more neutral, and either supporting the head on the hands, or if it's comfortable, forehead to floor, arms beside the body. Ideally, your buttocks would be sinking towards your heels. Because my right knee doesn't bend as much as I'd like it to, you'll find my hips are sticking up quite a bit, so don't copy me. If you can get the buttocks all the way to the heels, that's a better position for me. So I support my head because my hips are so high. I'm better off up here than with my head on the floor. So we breathe into the back, using that breath to extend into that lower back we were just bending into. And then we'll come back up. So coming onto our hands and our knees. And as we breathe in, we'll just do a gentle little dip through the back because we've already done some back bending. We don't have to overdo this one. The gaze comes forwards. On the exhale, let's just round out, draw in navel to spine as we stretch out through the shoulders. As we breathe in, step the right foot up to the hands. So if you want some extra padding underneath that back knee, feel free to put that down. So we're going to breathe in and lift the arms up into a lunge. Shoulders relaxed. And we want to check that the knee's not going past the ankle. So a little bit behind is okay. Directly over is okay. But this is putting a little bit too much stress here, so I'm going to back it off a little bit. We'll then bring the hands back down. We'll step back. And then from here, a little cat-cow roll. So we're going to breathe in, look forwards. Exhale, round it out. And next breath in, we'll step the left foot up towards the hands. When you're ready, lifting up, shoulders relaxed, finding this good positioning with the knee joint. And then lifting out of the hips, lengthening through the torso. We'll start to bring the hands back to the floor. Big step back. Just another little cat-cow roll. So we inhale, little dip, gaze forwards. And then exhale, tailbone down, navel in, relax the head. And then back to our neutral position. So we're going to walk the hands into the up on the knees. Again, if this isn't comfortable for your knees, a bit of padding, you could do this standing as well if you prefer to be off the knees completely. So we're going to interlock the hands. Inhale, take both arms up. And on the exhale, reaching over to the right hand side. So we keep pressing down through the legs, trying not to let this bottom arm get away from us. We'll come back to the center on the breath in. And then on the exhale, going to the other side. Being mindful of not twisting off with the upper body. All right, and release. So let's come back to center, bring the arms back down and shrug the shoulders out. And a little rotation through the wrists. All right, we'll be coming into our standing postures. So if you'd like to just take one foot forward, so I don't mind which one it is, that foot tucks under. Try to avoid pressing on your knee joint. So if you do have to press on something, press on the thigh. But if you can do it with no hands, even better. So we use the forward momentum and the push to come up. But if it's too much to do with our hands, put one hand on the thigh or two hands on the thigh. And we're up to stand. All right, so if you do have any equipment like blankets, etc., you may want to take that away from the mat. We're going to go sideways on the mat. So I'll step the feet out nice and wide. And we're going to our right side first. So we turn the right foot out 90 degrees and then extend away through the left heel. So roughly having the front heel and the instep of the back foot in line. When we bend our knee, that's what tells us we might have to change. So ideally this front kneecap is facing the middle part of our toes. If it's caving to the big toe like this, perhaps try repositioning the heel more in line with the back toes and see if that helps. So we're looking to open up the inner thigh here. We're sitting down with the buttocks and we're moving into angle pose. So we're going to rest our forearm on our thigh. A little rotation through this rib cage. And then if it's comfortable, reaching up that top left arm. If this isn't comfortable, just keep it on the hip. So gaze can either be to the top arm, or you can look straight ahead, or you could look to the floor. So we don't tend to look off to the side. Let's reach through the top arm, inhale all the way back out. And then we're going to change sides. So turning the feet. Make sure the back foot's turned slightly in on that right foot. We'll bend into the left knee. And then check, is the knee caving forwards? Do we need to correct that with a different foot position? So let's sit down. Start to lean over this left leg, rest the forearm. Little rotation through the ribs. And if it's comfortable, we take the top arm up. Shoulders relaxed away from the ears. Awareness to breath, soft face. And then we'll press down through the feet, reach to the top arm and coming all the way out. Now if you want to give the legs a little rest in between, you can. So if you check it out, we are going to go back to our right side to repeat this pose. Maybe going a little bit longer if it's comfortable. So when we bend the knee, we're trying to sit down a little bit deeper, get a little bit more length, if possible. So this time we'll take both arms out, shoulders relaxed. We're now in warrior two. You can turn, look down the right arm. And then we're going to reach a little further to the right. So let's extend out with that right arm, taking the body down. Again, you've got choice. You could place the forearm here on the thigh, or you can extend the hands a little more to the floor or even behind. So reach the top arm over and across. Lift and open the chest. Make sure that you can breathe. Press down through that back little toe side of the left foot. So a little bit stronger here, especially if you've got no support. You're using your core strength to hold the posture. Let's sweep the top arm down. Breathe in. Push through the legs. All the way out, relax the arms. Or other side. So turn the feet and rotate. Let's soften into that left knee. Inhale the arms. Warrior two first. So we can take the gaze down the left hand. Reach a little bit more through the right side to be centered. Now we start to extend a little deeper over that left side. And then your choice, either forearm resting on the thigh all going a little stronger behind or in front. Top arm sweeping over and across. And I don't want to look behind the arm. I want to look in front of the arm. So I've got to bring my shoulder back. Quite often we tend to want to collapse to the floor, but I'm lifting to the ceiling, the corner of the ceiling and the wall. While breathing, smiling, holding, maybe. You can always come out at any time. And then when you're ready to press through the foot, inhale, let's come all the way up. And we're going to walk the feet in. Heels, toes. And shake it out a little bit. And then we'll come into what we call Uttanasana. So our standing forward bend. I quite like to have the feet hip width, knees soft. So we fold from the hips. If you want to keep the head a little higher, you can rest here on the thighs. If it's comfortable, you can fold the arms and relax the head a little deeper. Try and rest the belly on the thighs so the back is supported. And just let ourselves hang to the floor. Releasing the arms, inhaling, bringing the gaze forward, so we're going to bend the knees a little deeper, and reach the arms behind, open the chest, lifting up, and then we use the legs to come all the way up, nice straight spine. Alright, now our next standing pose, we're going to be doing some twisting. So we haven't really done a lot of warm-up twisting yet, so what we'll do is just a nice, easy, loose, relaxed twist. Keep the knees soft. Maybe let the opposite heel come off the floor as we get a little bit more into it. All right, and we'll come back to our center. And then from here, let's breathe in, take both arms up. As we exhale, we're gonna split the arms out on the rotation. So they go shoulder height, and we're looking down the right. Then we breathe in, we come back to our center. Exhale, turn, rotate to the left. So we're going to do this another two times each way. This is our last one to the right. And last one to the left. Back to our center and release it back down. Alright, so twisting. Feet set up will be a little bit different. We are going to have the feet at least hip width. You could even go a little bit wider. And we're taking a big step forwards with our right foot. We will be going to the floor, so this is quite a long stance. So we have the front knee bent, and if we put the hands on the pelvis, let's see if we can ease the right hip back and the left hip forwards. So from here, let's come down into our long lunge. If you want to bring the hands a little higher, you could also have some supports under the hands. So from here, maybe take that left foot a little further back, maybe let the heel come off the floor. And then we're turning to our right side. So we're going to inhale, lift the head of the chest, keep the left hand on the ground, turn, and take that right arm up towards the ceiling. If it's not comfortable, put the hand on the hip. So let's release back to the floor. Place the back heel on the ground and we'll push back up. So you're finding that leg strength. All right, stepping forwards and we'll change sides. So left foot in front, big step back to the right, keeping that hip width distance. So I don't want my feet in line. I want to be able to bring my hips around, especially that right hip, as much as I can. All right, so from here, start to fold from the hips. We'll have the fingertips to the floor. Maybe readjust that back right heel off the ground. And then right hand staying on the ground, breathing in, exhaling, turning, Maybe left arm up, maybe hand on the hip. See how it feels. We'll take the top arm back down. So maybe readjust the heel down on that right foot, push through the legs, release, stepping forwards coming out. So that's our warm up. Okay, so taking that a little bit further, we are now going to go longer, deeper if we can with the stance. So let's take a big step forwards with the right foot. And I'm really trying to sink down here into my hips. So this time the left arm will be coming forward. So we're going to take a deep breath in. As we exhale, extend forwards. And you have the choice. You could bring fingertips a little closer to that right foot. You could hook the elbow to the outside of the knee and press the palms. Or you could put the hand on the other side of the foot. So any of these options are fine. If you're doing the hand on the floor, maybe taking that top arm up. But if you've got the bind, we hold the bind. And then we'll place the hands back down. We'll step forwards from here. Soft knees. Breathing in, slowly coming up. Check it out. So it's a little bit more warming, a little bit more energetic, this one. Let's try the other side. So left foot forwards. I've just changed direction so I can face the camera a little bit more easily on these twists. All right, so we're sitting right down, nice and long and low this time, if we can. Right hand extending, nice deep breath in. On the exhale, reaching forwards, and then deciding where you would like to place your arm. So if it's on the floor, again, we can come back, take the arm up. Keep going. For the twist, we press the palms. Can we breathe? That's what we're trying to do. We're going to release. We won't hold that one too long. Fingertips to floor. Big step forwards. Soft knees. Breathing in, bringing the head back up. Shake it out. And we should feel a little bit warmer after that one. Okay, so our next standing pose is straight legged and a fold from the hips. This one's called chest to leg extension. Can get quite intense. Quite often it is nice to have some bricks for the hands. So if you're doing this at home, which hopefully we all will be practicing at home very shortly, I think. Lunch boxes work well if you don't have yoga bricks. Also nice big heavy books. A nice option as well. So we'll place the bricks either side and we'll be stepping the right foot forwards. And again, I want that hip width distance. So if I can get both feet pointing to the top of the mat, that's going to make it easier to get the length in my spine. So if we put the hands on top of the pelvis here, we're going to breathe in, lengthen through the front body. As we exhale, we try and fold from our hip creases. So we're just coming halfway. And we really need to draw up through these leg muscles. So really lifting up these thighs. I'm trying to ease my right hip back, ease the left hip forwards, without sort of rounding my back too much. So watching not tucking down with the tailbone. See if you can lift the sit bones up a little bit. Take the shoulders back. So let's release the hands onto our support. So we want them underneath the shoulders. And then make sure that we haven't sort of relaxed those legs. So we're going to draw up through the legs. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Back up through our tailbone. And we should be feeling a good opening in our right buttocks, hamstrings. Maybe a good stretch in the left calf muscle. Alright, so for a moment we're going to bend that front right knee. Bring the body lower down on the thigh, and you can certainly allow the hands to come to a comfortable position. again, that breath in, lengthen through the back. And this is where it gets tricky. On the exhale, we're going to see if we can fold over the thigh as we straighten into our right leg again. So you may need to bring the hands back up high. And we just relax our forehead towards the shin. Stay with that breath. Keep pressing through the left back heel. So now bending into the right knee, take a breath in, look forwards. From here, it is easier to step forwards with the bent knee. So we're going to do that, soften the knees again. As we come up, you'll probably notice it here in the right body. So let's go for a little walk. Just loosen that out before we do the other side. Okay. So reset. If you can bring those bricks back up high. So now we'll take our left foot forwards. Hands on the top of the pelvis. Are both feet pointing in the same direction? So if I let this foot turn out, if I want to go this direction, my foot's staying that direction. I'm fighting myself. So that's why I want to pivot and see if I can get everything going in the same direction. So hands on the pelvis. Halfway first. So let's take a breath in. Lengthen through the front spine. As we exhale, we're folding from these hip creases. We're coming just that halfway point. Drawing up strong through the legs, pressing through the feet. Little lift at the sit bones if we can, shoulders back. Try not to collapse all of that when we bring the hands down to our supports. So can we ease the left hip back a little bit more? Keep drawing up the kneecaps. Just allowing this sensation to settle. How's the breath? Expand and contract in the belly. And then we'll bring a bit of softness now to that left knee. So with that, as we bring our torso lower on the thigh, we can now bring those hands lower. Again, work the left hip back a little bit. And then the final part of the pose, we're going to breathe in, lengthen. On the exhale, we start to ease back through that left leg. Relax the forehead more towards the shin. And if you need to bring the hands back up higher, that's perfectly normal. So do that, modify to suit. So we'll soften again into the left knee. Take the gaze forwards. Big step up. Soft knees. Inhale. Roll it all the way up. Probably feeling it in the left buttock now, so let's go for a little walk. Shake that out. That feels good. Alright, so no more standing postures. We're going to come into Uttanasana again, our standing forward bend, and then from there we'll make our way to the floor. So we start with the soft knees, fold from the hips, and either elbows resting here if it's comfortable, fold the arms, relax the head, and let it go. So let's release the hands all the way to the floor. Now, depending on where you are on your mat, we're going to bring ourselves into a plank position. So, for me, I'll be walking my hands forwards. You might have to walk your feet back. And we come into a straight line through the body. Now, if this is not good for your wrists, feel free to modify on forearms. And if you, again, need to take it down a notch, you can also put the knees on the floor, but if you're happy to hold a full plank, we lift the spine between the shoulder blades, reach back through the heels, and try and keep the head in line with the rest of the spine, so I'm not looking up and I'm not looking down. How's that breath going? Alright, let's take both knees to floor, release, relax into a child pose, whichever child pose you prefer. You can take the knees wider if you like. And then we'll come back up. So we're going to be moving from our plank position into a side plank position. Again, there's a few ways we can do this. First one, we're going to have the feet on the floor, but we're going to have one leg in front. So I'll show you my right side first. Come around this way. So if we can have the right hand planted on the floor, and then from here, we'll extend back through the right leg. So a nice straight line through there. Again, those with wrists, you could do this on the forearm as well. And then we'll take the left foot off the mat just to the side, knee bend. So we're going to turn and rotate and take the left arm up. So it's a little bit of a twisted side plank. So lower version, you could do this with knee on the floor, you could be down here, a little bit tougher on the shoulder. Okay, come back down. And we'll transfer to the other side. So left hand will stay on the floor, we extend the left leg back. We'll take the right foot up and over. And then turn and rotate, right arm up to ceiling. And we breathe. Top arm back down, knees to floor, and again, give the body a rest. Certainly rotating to the wrists if they feel they would like that. And then we'll come back up. Last burst of energy before we wind down. If possible, we'll be doing full plank into full side plank, or you could do a half plank with knees on the floor, and then you can switch the feet behind, and this is your half plank, side plank, or forearm on the floor, knees on the floor, modified version. So any one of these. So let's either start from a cat position, or for those who are okay to do it, let's start from a full plank position. We reach back through the heels. So from here, let's turn the right foot over, or knees on the floor, feet over to the right. Lift up through the left arm, keep the legs strong, shoulders back, head back. And then we'll bring that top arm back down. If you can continue to the other side, or hold in plank, or rest. So we're going to turn the left foot over, or left knee on the floor, switch it around, lifting up nice and tall. Don't forget to breathe. Legs are glued together if we can. Alright, top arm back down. Both knees to floor. Have a rest. Really good. On the floor, and if it's comfortable, could turn your head down to the left arm, or you can keep it looking to the ceiling. So we still focus the breath to the belly. And then we'll inhale, come back to our centre. When we come out, it feels crooked. That's normal. So I'm just going to realign. And then we lift the hips up, shift them to the right, put them back down. Roll both knees to our left. So I've got my right foot resting on top of my left. And then either head to centre or turn to the right. And we're focusing the breath here down at the belly. So we soften on the exhale. Breathe in, come back to centre, realign the back so it feels straight, and then we'll tug the knees in towards the chest, nice little squeeze, go for a little rock, whatever feels good, and then release the feet back to the floor. Alright, so from here we will be getting comfortable for a relaxation. So if you do want to put something warm on and perhaps put something underneath the knees, if you like to have the knees bent when you relax, get whatever equipment you want. I'm just going to get a top. So we started the class with awareness of our three-part yogi breath. So once you have yourself in your comfortable position, can you focus back to that three-part breath? Sending the breath down into the lower lungs, letting the belly expand, allowing the breath to expand into the ribs, and then topping up at the collarbones. Softening on that exhale. Just a couple more conscious breaths. And then allowing that breath to settle into its own natural rhythm. Following that natural flow of air in through the nose, out through the nose. Aware of the four parts of the breath. So we have our inhalation, and then there's a little pause before we start the exhalation. And at the end of the exhalation, there's another pause in the breath before. being aware of those four parts, the inhale, the pause, the exhale, and the pause. So imagine yourself setting out on a journey to climb a sacred mountain. And you know that this is going to be a long and difficult climb, but you're sure that you will reach the summit. And you leave your hometown to meet your guide. This is a person who you haven't met before, but you know that they're qualified and experienced. And you find it difficult to assess this person's character. They're not very talkative, but you want to make the journey, so you follow him. He leads you out of the town and through a large forest. You walk underneath the canopy of the trees and cross many streams. Eventually, you come to an enormous lake. Got that beautiful mountain blue colour. It's very clear, very fresh. And you stop here for a while, drink the water, take a rest. And then you continue on the journey. You get to feel a little frustrated and a bit of mistrust with the guide, as the forest is now so dense that you can't see far in any direction. This sacred mountain is completely obscured and you feel very far from home. After a little time, you start to ascend and the forest becomes less dense. And when you look back in the direction where you came from, you can see the forest and the rooftops of your town. And the sight of the town, the tiredness in your body, begins to make you feel that the journey is perhaps useless, a little harder than you thought. It'd be much easier to return to the comforts of your home and the friends you've left behind. But the guide insists that you go on, so you follow. The ascent becomes steeper and you're feeling tired, but the guide continues at their steady pace. And sometimes you feel angry at his relentless pace, but at other times you're grateful for his expertise in climbing the more difficult terrain and avoiding the places it would have been impossible for you to climb. The vegetation becomes less dense, the ground is rocky and rugged, and all thoughts of home and past have gone, as you need to concentrate completely on climbing and keeping up with the guide. Overcome by fatigue, you collapse on the ground to rest. You feel exhausted and defeated, and you don't care if the guide waits for you or not. The whole journey seems pointless. But the guide comes back and takes you by the hand and starts walking again. And with each step, he repeats the words, "I will." You find that you are walking in step with him. And the sound of the words, "I will," is echoing through your body and mind, giving you tremendous strength and energy. The guide releases your hand, but the words keep resounding in your mind as you follow him further upwards. You near the top of the sacred mountain. Here the ascent is even more difficult. It seems like the guide is far ahead of you. But you trudge languidly on alone and finally reach the top where the guide is waiting for you. Now you observe the spectacular panoramic view. A feeling of exhilaration floods through your body and mind. And the guide gives you a meaningful smile. And you are grateful to him for his forcefulness during the climb. You're overcome by a feeling that you have never experienced before. And you enjoy that sense of accomplishment.
is something that we should welcome, for without change, nothing in this world would ever grow or blossom. And no one in this world would ever move forward to become the person they're meant to be. I'm going through a bit of change at the moment. Let's hope we all grow the better for it. Namaste. Down.